This is Randy Quaid, and despite blocking their silly asses on Twitter, I want you to listen to the Three Geeks podcast.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Three Geeks podcast. That was really nice of Randy Quaid to...
not really Randy Quaid.
That was not a disclaimer.
Not really Randy Quaid.
Flashing at the bottom. Fantastic.
Yeah. Oh, hey. Okay. Never mind.
This is the first show we've done without John or Mike.
Do you feel like naked?
I do a little bit. That means, you know, Asians can safely listen to our podcast today.
This one, we'll see how this episode does in China.
They can drink Tsingtao and everything. It'd be great.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the podcast. Jason joined by Max, Dan, Scott, as usual, with Ryan joining us today. We've got Justin coming up at 1 o'clock to talk about his podcast and some of the things that he's got going on, and then our top 5 animated movies.
Disney movies.
Oh, geez.
I'm not opening up that can of worms.
I got to remake that list now.
Podcast for that conversation, sir.
We were making this list prior, and I can't even imagine if it was opened up. It would have been a nightmare.
Probably would have been easy. I wouldn't be as much Disney on it.
We do have a new logo that was designed by our buddy Brian from Staunch Ambition.
Please don't sue us.
What's that?
I said, please don't sue us.
Yeah.
So, thanks, Brian.
Yeah, that's all on the side. That's awesome.
Yeah. Right, I have both of those.
Repping nope, Mike. Shit.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, over there. Over there.
How are you guys doing today?
Yeah, it's someone.
Good. Max, take over talking while I blow this up.
I am taking over the talking. Okay, did anyone watch Mulan? Am I the only one who watched it?
Yeah, I didn't get a chance to.
All right, well, I'm going to talk about it. This is what we're talking about.
I heard it was bad. Mulan.
This is the only Disney live-action movie from an animated movie that I was excited for because I was like, Kung Fu. And like they've been making these, like, if you go to China, like, just FYI, they make epic historical Chinese movies there all the time. They have these giant budget movies and they're decent and the kung fu is awesome and they've been doing it for years. So I don't understand why when Disney is telling a historical Chinese story, why they wouldn't just buy one of these companies that have been making historical Chinese movies and have them make a movie. It's really like I see where they're kind of like trying to do this like whitewashed, like, oh, you see, we're celebrating Chinese culture sort of deal, but like,
was Matt Damon in it?
Matt Damon was not in it, thankfully.
Affleck,
huh?
Ben Affleck in it?
No, Ben Affleck. Tom Cruise was also not in it.
What?
I just know they like those kind of
movies. I'm like, good on them for, you know, like actually hiring Chinese people, I guess. But like, that's about as far as they went. And like the movie is just very blah. The kung fu is not great. Donnie Yen is in it, but like,
is he really?
Yeah. But they speed him up. Like when he's supposed to be looking sweet doing kung fu, like it's obviously sped up. And it's like they're using just old tricks from the 70s, and it's like just not good. I was unimpressed. It was the only one I was looking forward to seeing, and it was just a complete letdown. I've talked to some other people who saw that one and then have seen the other live action Disney movies, and they're like, "Yeah, this is like the worst one," and I'm bummed out because I thought this was a good, I was hoping for more, and you know, I they did not deliver. It was not worth the $30 I spent to stream it early on the fucking Disney Plus. Like, that was, if you can not do this, like, just pop in the animated Mulan. Don't worry about it. Like, don't worry about seeing this live action one. It's weird. I miss the fucking songs. You know, like I didn't think I would. I was like, there's no songs. I was like, awesome. This is going to be more of a historical sort of thing. You know, it's going to have a more realistic feel to it. Bullshit. Give me the songs back. Give me the dragon back. Fucking all this shit you had was bullshit. Like, just make the fucking cartoon the movie. Don't do any of the shit you did. That's it.
So they didn't include the songs in this one because
there's like two times where the song is like playing, the melody of the song is playing in the background, but right when they start the training, the make a man out of you, that song, you hear the music, but like they're not singing, and it's not the same. And I surprised myself when I was disappointed about the music. Like, looking back after I'd finished the movie, I was like, they should have sung the songs. Like, they should have given me something. I don't even know. Like, it's...
Wow, Disney broke free from their own formula.
Oh, yeah. What's the main one? Like, the "Where Will My Reflection Show?" That song plays in the background like 8 times, but give me a break. That song...
But does it have ancient, Chinese battle crabs?
Ancient Chinese what now?
Battle crabs.
Battle crabs.
Yeah, you can't have old, like war scenes without giant battle crabs.
You're talking about the giant enemy crab from the Sony E3? And you attack its weak point for massive damage? That's a deep dive there, Dan.
I know.
Well,
it has nothing to do with Mulan.
But I will tell you that there are no ancient battle crabs in this movie. Might have been giant, better than battle crabs.
It's giant enemy crab. Let's at least get the terminology right.
Yeah, I want music.
Giant battle crab.
You know what? Like, I hope you're ready for. I think it's next Tuesday. Like, or is it this coming up Tuesday? This coming up Tuesday, Rondell. The draft is happening, and I'm taking you down this year.
Rondell, I sent you the link, man. Join the stream for a few minutes. We'd love to have you on here with us.
Yes.
I'm super surprised because, like, looking back on it, I'm like, what could have made this movie better? Fuck it. Put the songs back in. Do something.
Wow, they usually
just remaster the original.
Yeah, I'm like, give me a remastered Mulan movie.
Not sell it for $30.
Right? Yeah. Like, put it out there. Like, here you go. Here's our crap movie. Like, I would not be this upset if I didn't spend $30. Like, if you're in a family, if you got like two kids, $30 for the Mulan movie is a steal. Okay. Anyway, $30 is a steal for a family of four to get this movie. But I'm just one dude who watched this movie, and I'm pissed off that I spent $30 on it.
Like, but is it really like worth it? If for your family at home,
yeah. No, if you're a parent,
I don't know.
Yes.
Well, would it still entertain children?
Entertain children. Yeah, it's still a Disney movie. There's still like fun things for the kiddos, I suppose.
But I mean, you're already paying for Disney Plus.
Right. So this is an extra $30.
So why spend the extra $30
If you have the family and you've watched everything else and this is something for you. Like, it's $30 and that's an hour and a half that you're not gonna have to worry about anything except for the fact that you've now made your children dumber for watching this movie. You should have just watched the regular Mulan.
It's like
that's what I'm saying.
Dumber for having watched this movie.
But I mean, like, it will entertain them. There's flashing colors and bright lights and people kick things. But God, disappointment. Very, very big disappointment.
How many geeks?
Give me my $30 back. That's how many geeks it gets.
Max is going to be suing Mulan.
Suing the ancient Chinese legend Mulan.
I'm just kidding.
Should have listened to those protesters.
Disney, we love you. Don't kill us.
And they will.
disappointment. I'm glad none of you guys watched it though. Like, I mean, Fuzzy, again, like if you need to, you know, the kids are getting on your last damn nerve and you don't know what else to do, spend the $30, plop them in front of
the $30. If Tatiana wants to review it for us, we'll send you the
you can watch it anyway.
There we go.
But plop them in front of there. But again, you are like me possibly doing lasting damage to your children. But it will shut them up for an hour and a half. Like, you will achieve what you set out to.
There's a lot of value for $30 for shutting your kids up for an hour and a half.
See?
Ten bucks for 30 minutes? I'd cut that check a bit.
I figured. Again, this is not an experience of mine, but I know that they priced it at a point where people are like, oh, this is good. This is, you know, less than tickets and popcorn and the hassle of going to the theater.
The risk.
And the risk. So yeah. But no, it was not good. 1 out of 3 geeks. It's just very blah. And
that's sad because I know how excited you were for it.
Yeah.
It's funny how this worked out because this is the one I've liked some of the reboots, but this is the one I absolutely had no interest in seeing, and this is the one Max was excited about. So
yeah, and that's what I get. That's what I get.
Fuzzy, what do you think of the Disney reboot so far as a parent?
I don't know if we've ever watched any of them with my son, actually. they actually really annoy me because, like, we'll throw on, like, you know, we'll tell Alexa to go and play, like, Disney songs. And every time it comes on with, like, one of the remake versions of the songs, I always, like, skip the song because it just too many decades in the background of the song being ingrained in, I can see when it skips or it makes the melody go a little longer so they can dance. And I'm like, I can't do that. It always just it breaks me a little bit when I'm sitting there trying to be like, oh, wait, nope. Wait, nope.
That's a good choice, Aaron. He says he's gonna wait till the when they release it for free.
Good on you, man. You know, or don't. Yeah, like, just don't even watch it. Just watch the regular Mulan. You're not going to be sad about it. If you enjoyed Mulan before, I guarantee you still enjoy it.
And that's one of the best sight gags I've ever seen in a movie, the original Mulan. Like, towards the end when they're all getting ready to, like, invade the palace and they need to dress up like women, and they all, like, they put, you know, fruit in their shirt to make them look like large breasts, and one guy carves a fucking banana. Like, I saw it, I was like, that is just wonderful writing. That is excellent craftsmanship of a visual show.
Yes, see, it's got everything. It's got everything.
And more happy news, we got the release date for Mandalorian Season 2. It comes out October 30th.
Baby Yoda. So, like, do you think it's going to be toddler Yoda? Like, you know, is he stopping and force crushing things? Or, you know, like, are they going to do, like, a Groot thing?
I think Infant Yoda is still way too marketable. I think they're gonna try and wring a little bit more out of that, and then maybe season 3 you'll get toddler Yoda.
Like, I think Favreau's got a little more clout. So, like, if that doesn't, you know, if that's not the story he wants to tell,
that's I agree. I think, like, if that's the way he wants to go, then more power to him. I'm just like
hoping.
Like, I can see him being like, "No, more baby. We didn't get the toys out in time for last season. We're gonna do it this time."
Yeah, I can't wait for teenage Yoda.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, is he going to be like a smarmy fucking smart aleck, like, you know, pulling force pranks on the Mandalorian, like, making him see shit that's not there and whatnot? I'm down for that.
Let's see what this is all about.
What is this? This is a concept. This isn't a real trailer.
This is a concept.
Is it?
Yeah. Jason, you're always doing this, bro.
Concept trailer is still something.
But it's not anything.
It's not real.
Yeah.
It's all just...
It's not real?
No.
No.
Somebody made this. That's Boba Fett.
Yeah. No. I was just
trying to... That's fucking Boba Fett. Boba Fett.
Discord player.
Oh, my God.
Look, guys, it's his first day.
It is. I just like
fucking intern. No, but I'm excited for Mandalorian season two. It was good. First season was good. Hopefully, the second season just carries on that quality.
Anything that you hope you don't see in the Mandalorian season two? Like, what if they started introducing characters that we know exist?
I really don't want to see that. I don't want to.
They're already going to do that. Apparently, we're going to get Ahsoka and Boba.
Oh, Ahsoka Tano! God.
I mean, we knew that was coming because they're all the same.
God.
An Elder Jar Jar.
Oh, there we go.
No, because I found out Jar Jar is he's a street worker now because he's been punished for putting the senator in power. So now he's like a goof that lives on the streets of Taboo.
Good. That's what he deserves.
I don't think that's canon, but
it's in the Aftermath, book 3. I could tell you the exact thing that he's doing.
There it is.
It's Aftermath canon.
Yeah, it came out.
Jar Jar is a street sweeping hobo.
I'll be here in a second.
The Wikipedia.
That's what I'm doing. No, I'm not Wikipedia. I'm regular Googling it.
Yeah, a real legit website.
Did we get the baby Hutt again?
Can you show us the concept trailer?
I really don't care that much, honestly.
Oh no, you're throwing down the gauntlet, Scott. This will be.
I'm sure
we need pages and citations at this point.
Oh goodness sake! I heard that they're giving Favreau like more Star Wars stuff to do, like maybe movies. I'm down for that. But
anyway, one of the lines from the book is, "Me no so sure the Gungan makes a hmm sound. Misa thinks it's cuz of Jar Jar making some mistakes. Big mistakes. Sir Gunga boss is banished."
Please stop.
It's so hard to read that.
Please stop.
I think Chase is having a stroke. Please help him.
Yeah.
I just had a
stroke. Jar Jar sucks so bad. Why didn't they make him just dead? Why couldn't he just come across the gravesite of Jar Jar Binks? Why?
I don't know.
What a terrible character.
Yeah. Like he got set on fire and like thrown out the window or something at the end of the rebellion.
Oh man, he's gonna get Jar Jar. What's that? Oh well, that's when.
There you go.
You know, and then like 35 horrible things later, they're like, "Jesus Christ, I hope I never get Jar Jar."
Well, I forgot to mention at the top of the hour, today's podcast is brought to you by
Taco Bell. Presents its newest entree, as seen in the hit movie Showgirls. Nomi gobbled them up on screen, and now you can get your hands on Nomi's beefy fish taco. Engulf all the voluptuous flavors in your mouth. Available in plain, smothered with our patented crispy sauce. So go to Taco Bell and get a Naomi's beefy fish taco, available at all locations only after midnight.
What is beefy fish taco
sauce? I don't know, but I want it.
Definitely check out. Puzzy just looked shocked when I started that video.
Oh, I'm just more confused. When did you guys start getting production values? I mean, not a lot, but just a little
bit. Yeah, yeah.
It's good, right?
That was done by Dan and John. Give credit where credit's due.
That was John. I just invented the beefy fish taco.
You asked for more moaning in the background, wasn't that you?
Yes, and squirting sounds.
Yeah, see, you really sold the idea.
Moist.
Yes.
Moist. Called in the Randy Quaid bit me and John did.
Oh my goodness, I want to like hang out with Randy Quaid looking like that, Yeah.
Yeah, in your nearest park with like a piece of cardboard.
Like, seriously, it looks like Santa Claus after a bender.
Oh my goodness, like no buttons down on the polo shirt. Like I love it.
I mean, look how far.
So hungry, please give food.
One to the other.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Looking like a disgruntled Santa Claus. I want to hang out with that guy.
We should. I want to get him on the podcast, but he won't talk to us anymore. He blocked us.
Yeah. Because the request you sent was like full fanboy. It was.
Yeah.
It had to be blocked. You're a stalker, so nice. Dude. So you're nice. A stalker, dude.
Whatever. I'm the nicest guy in podcasting.
Well, Randy Quaid thinks you're a stalker.
Well, yes. Randy Quaid is also very into certain people that will not be named on this podcast.
Well, good for Randy Quaid. I want to hang out with that guy.
Did you watch Star Trek Lower Decks? Are you caught up?
Yes.
What do you think of the series so far? Because I know you're really big into Star Trek.
I'm very pleased that it's pretty much written for me because they're very much going after Star Trek Next Generation, which was pretty much what was the big thing there. I mean, you know, growing up, that's what we all watched as a family. And nice story. Like the series finale was the day my dad actually came home from the hospital after getting in this car accident. We were able to actually all watch it together. But no, I'm very much enjoying it. I'm finding it very, very good. It's pleasing me every time.
I wasn't a huge fan of the first episode, but the second episode was a definitely positive direction. Does it continue to get better and better each episode?
Yes, it definitely is. They are going deeper into it. It's quality stuff. The first episode was very amusing because my wife is also very excited, but she has a very deep zombie phobia. So, like, most of the time through the episode, I'm just looking next to her and going, I'm so sorry, I didn't know. There's no way I could know.
She's even like, animated zombies?
It's fine. Like, it's like to the point, it's not even funny to even joke around her because, like, it'll give her nightmares, which in turn means that she's going to wake up and then wake me up. Right. Like, it's just not even worth it. It's not even worth it.
This laugh is not worth my sleep.
It's really. I have to tell my siblings. I'm like, guys, it's please don't. Like, it's funny, yes, but it keeps me up at night. The moment it inconveniences me, that's when I have to pull the plug on that.
So you would never get up before her and go make yourself look like a zombie and then lay back down.
No, she'd stab me.
Like, yeah, in the head. Like,
not like one time either. It'd be like. Every night for the rest of my life, she'd stab me in my sleep.
Go in. Yep, stab you again. Yeah, well
at least the good
you know, is you know how things go.
She'll want to stab you every day, so she's going to make sure she doesn't kill you when she stabs you. So, yeah, I've got going for you.
Yeah, that'd be a small bonus. We'll go through sheets, though, like a lot, I'm sure.
No, eventually you're just gonna Dexter it up, right? Like everything in plastic, you just sleep on top of that.
Awesome. So what's everybody watching? Was anybody watching anything fun?
I've been watching the Symbionic Titan for Animaniacs. They just dropped that on Netflix. I've been really enjoying that.
Oh, good. We're gonna get a positive Animaniacs.
Gendy Tartakovsky. Oh, it's Gendy Tartakovsky. Like he's like my favorite animator of all time. Studio Ghibli can suck it.
I've started listening to Animaniacs since I've started transferring them to video, so I've been listening to all of them. And every episode I've heard, like the last three, have not been super positive.
We haven't had a hit.
No, the last one was okay. You just haven't gotten to that one yet.
Oh yeah, I know. I'm talking about the ones that have aired.
Yeah.
The audience hasn't heard that one yet either.
We haven't had a good hit in a while. There's no freaking Mrs. Takazawa, but it's you just gotta keep trying. And we haven't had a good Dan pick in a while.
Yeah,
no. That's a new one.
George R. Sith Lord bullshit. I don't want to hear that shit in the comments.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But so you just gotta keep looking. You just gotta keep trying. So keep listening to Animaniacs. We're gonna have some good stuff on there.
We're gonna do Symbionic on the Titan, and it's probably gonna be really positive.
Yeah, and then. Primal Season 2 comes out in October, so...
In like a month.
Yeah. Yay.
That's, and Gendy. I mean, come on! Gendy!
Nice. Robert Pattinson has been diagnosed with COVID. Batman production was on for a week, and then it got shut down again.
Then even Batman can catch COVID.
The Rock had COVID, too. Him and
he probably caught it so he could, like, cure himself and then cure the world. That's like a Batman thing to do.
If The Rock dies from COVID, I think we're all doomed. Like, none of us are
safe.
None of us are safe.
Who will be in everything?
There's that. But also, who will watch the Rock movie? You know, because we'll all be dead from COVID because it could even kill the Rock.
That's crazy. But I know Max is really hoping that Pattinson gets better.
So yeah, you know, like, I don't care. I don't care about Batman. Like, what upsets me is, like, the longer that Batman has COVID, the longer I have to wait to see the Batmobile in this movie. I don't, like, they could have, like, just show me a panorama or whatever, just circling the Batmobile for 45 minutes, and you maybe then drive it in one direction. I that's three geeks for me. Hands down, best Batman movie ever made. I don't, like, I just want to see this car. I love it so much.
Have they showed us the car yet?
Yes.
Or, okay.
Ish.
Yeah, so you get a little bit.
It's an actual car. It's not a tank.
No, it's a car.
Okay, cool.
Like an El Camino?
More like a GTO, I think. But an El Camino is a car. Like the Batmobile is a car.
Okay, good.
I mean, you could make a Batmobile El Camino. That could be cool.
That I'm down for that, too. But this Batmobile that they made, which is not an El Camino, is awesome.
But you could... The El Camino is just driving to jail.
See, there it is. There it is right there. Look at that thing.
It's the best looking one I could find.
Yeah. This is good. We don't have a lot. You know what I'm saying? Like, they haven't given us a lot to work with. Okay. And I just want to see this car in action. I just want to see him drive this car, maybe over somebody. I don't know.
They can always recast Patrick.
Right. That's what I'm saying. Like, the car is built. Like, who cares who's playing Batman? The car is built. Like, let's get this thing unbuilt.
They've got the technology now to put people's faces on other people's faces. Come on, all you're doing is just showing this part of the face when he's playing Batman.
Right? Like, fuck, man. Like, this is not hard. I mean, show me this fucking car!
You can even take a mustache off of somebody's face. I mean...
Yeah, this might take my most favorite, like, Batmobile. This might be it. I don't know. Like, but we have to see. And I can't see until fucking Robert Pattinson gets over COVID. So suck it up, you fucking wuss.
But we hope Robert Pattinson gets well.
Rip me a little baby, you fucking put that bat suit on and you fill my car, you fucking asshole. Whatever.
That Batmobile is just sitting in the garage somewhere waiting.
You listen up here, Twilight. You fucking get your shit together.
Jesus. But yeah, we got Pattinson's news and The Rock's news. I'm going to pull up some news sites here and see what else we got for the week.
I heard, didn't The Rock's whole family get COVID?
Yeah, the whole family. Yep.
Oh, jeez.
We have not heard those reports from like anybody yet, but The Rock's family gets it all. You have COVID.
It's like Tom Hanks level.
Yeah.
Star Trek Discovery Season 3 will feature the franchise's first non-binary and transgender characters.
Hey.
That's in line with Star Trek, though.
Wait, no. That's not true at all. Next Gen had a whole fucking race of people who were, like, not one gender or the other.
Granted, like, the main person they showed on that one decided they were a gender.
Okay, but then the rest of them came and sterilized her brain. I'm just saying.
Yeah.
I'm just saying they exist.
I like getting Scott all worked up about Star Trek.
Oh, no, but I dropped that fucking knowledge on him, Scott. Like, debunked, motherfuckers. Like, you don't get the medal for this one.
We all know what Scott's thoughts are, but Fuzzy, what are your thoughts of Discovery of Picard?
I enjoy them both. Give me as much as you possibly can. I thought, Picard was great. Once again, just playing directly to my nostalgia, I was perfectly fine with that. It's like, yeah, fine, just show me more of it. Do it. I'll draw them out 10 hours. I'll watch them.
This is nice.
Bring them all back. Bring them all. Do it.
Now, fucking Scott would be a good duo to review Star Trek with each other.
Yeah, we can possibly get to...
I'm sure Scott would do that.
I would. Yeah. Let's do it.
I don't need a reason to not sit around and watch Star Trek. Pretty much what I do.
So, I've avoided talking about this, but should we talk about the Ray Fisher stuff? The one who's
accused what?
All of the misconduct on the set of Justice League, like the abuse.
I have not heard about
yeah,
this.
Yeah, I didn't hear about it. What is
I heard a little bit because they're comparing him to who's the other person?
Because I guess he said some stuff about Geoff Johns, and yeah. Warner Brothers is like, we never said to bury Geoff Johns, and then he released the message that he got from Warner Brothers saying to stop talking about Geoff Johns, just put it all on John. I'm like, dude, you're still working for the company technically. Like, they're putting out your movie in like less than a year.
Well, they have to. COVID, bro. Like, he's like, I'm untouchable.
I did check out Bad Boys for Life this week. I hadn't seen it yet.
Yeah, I thought that one was better than the second one. It was definitely a return to more good, funny. Bad Boys.
I gotta sit on it a little longer, but I haven't seen one in a while. Two is the one that's more fresh in my memory, but I thought three might be better than the other two. Just because it has the action that you love from one, and it had a better thought out story, I thought, than the first two.
One was its own thing. It was totally fine. I thought, hey, you're in Miami, they're doing drugs, there's cops, they're you know, it's Black Lethal Weapon. You know what I'm saying? Like,
I am glad
they
didn't play Mexico at the end of Battle.
Right. You know what I'm saying? Like, everything that happens, the last scene is just on an airfield. Like it's not anything crazy. I disagree with you as far as like the story.
For life,
the story of three is ridiculous. Now we have this super high tech fucking road crew, like Will Smith's own personal fucking ninja team. Get the fuck out of here, dude. Like, no, the story is not more believable than the first one. That is an invalid argument.
I did have a little water in my eyes with Joey Pants.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, like,
Will Smith doesn't have a ninja team?
I'm sure, like, Will Smith has a ninja team, but he's also not a Miami police officer. Will Smith and had the ninja team, but he can't also be a police officer.
I don't
remember
a ninja team in this movie. There's like one guy that did ninja. There was a tech person.
That's why I said they need a team, okay? One guy's a little infiltrator guy, then you have the tech guy, you have the ammo guy, you have the... No. This would never... No. It's all dumb. It's all ridiculous. This one is more ridiculous than any, like, not more ridiculous than two, because, again, they did not invade a foreign country.
The ending of this one, when they do go into the foreign country, is way more believable than the ending of two.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure. Oh, I guess they did invade a foreign country in this one, too.
Not really. They just invaded a room. They didn't come in with, like, helicopters and planes. Yeah.
The whole fucking militia.
Missiles, the U.S. Army.
Utter ridiculousness. But no, I did enjoy this one more than two. I thought, like, I wish... I don't even want to think about two. We'll just make this one two.
One.
Call it a day.
They did miss an opportunity because they obviously set up another movie at the end of this one. So calling
Bad
Boys for Life. Now what are you going to do with the fourth movie?
There's no fourth movie. What are you going to call it? Will Smith's Ninja Squad? No. It's done.
One of my favorite horror franchises is returning. I am super curious to see how this goes. The original cast has set to return. Neve Campbell, Courtney Cox, and David Arquette. Who is the team behind
Didn't they all do this the last time they did this?
Yeah, and it was good.
Yeah, it was all right.
Ready or Not directors are set to helm this one.
I liked Ready or Not, though.
We talked about this a little bit on Friday Geeks, but I'm curious to see where somebody that's not Wes Craven takes this franchise with the original players.
Yeah, we've seen a lot of things with it depends on who the right person is. So, like, if you look at, like, the Creed franchise or what's another one where it's, like, kind of an offshoot, but it's, like, fans taking – but, even The Mandalorian, you know, when you get the right person in charge of the thing, could be good. I don't know how much, like, because the Scream, the story is the same. You know, it's just like some dude running around with a knife. Like, it's
Well, the one thing I liked about Scream 4, and a lot of horror franchises can't do this because they kill their leads every other movie, but one thing that I really liked about 4 is they were able to bring back the original crew from the first three movies, and they were able to really like just go at horror remakes. And I thought that that was handled really well, and that's one of the reasons I really like Scream.
So now, after they've gone after horror remakes, they're going to remake a horror movie? Like,
no, they're actually going to try to do a historic Chinese epic.
Oh, you know, hey, they probably do it better than Disney.
They're going to do it right this time.
I'm down. I'm down for that.
Army of David Arquette's going to be he'll be the Mulan.
Yes, David Arquette cast as Mulan. I like it. I'm down. Courtney Cox gets to play her David Arquette's father.
I mean, it writes itself, guys.
Courtney Cox is David Arquette's father?
Yeah, well, if he's Mulan, then she gets to play his father.
Yeah. And then the end is going to be in a giant wrestling ring with David Arquette and, I don't know,
Courtney Cox playing his father.
How excited are you? Like, do you think David Arquette just sits around his house waiting for a call to do?
No, I feel like he has got a treadmill. You know, I feel like he's got a phone. Yeah, like, he's not just waiting for the phone call. There are things that David Arquette can do. I'm sure he's got a hobby of some sort.
Wrestling?
No, he's been wrestling.
Oh, he has he actually been wrestling?
Yeah, yeah. Like he's been trying to get that stain from you know having the WCW title back in the 2000s gone.
Oh man, that's awesome! Like I wouldn't do wrestling just because like I'm not down for the physical toll.
Yes,
grab death machine.
You know, like I'm not trying to get tossed around. That just seems like a lot. David Arquette is what, like 50 something?
He's got to be, yeah.
Not for me, bud. Not for me. Good on you.
Yeah, he's got a movie coming out about his wrestling on the indie scene.
David Arquette is 48 years old. Courtney Cox is 56.
Yeah.
Jesus fucking Christ. She is still, like, adorable. All right.
I feel like she's surgeried up.
It doesn't matter. So, David Arquette was a former WCW champion.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry. I was looking something up.
yeah, no, it's he did like get. I thought he was ECW though. I don't know why.
No, because they brought in Russo to do the writing, and it got all shitty. And then they're trying to promote the Ready to Rumble movie, and then he became champ, and then everything just went down the fucking toilet.
Dude, so, I dig that movie. I like it way more than I should, or at all.
Yeah. I haven't seen it in a long time, but it's, I remember.
It's not good, but it's oddly nostalgic for me.
Wow. Yeah, David Arquette, man. That's something.
The storied life of David Arquette.
I can't believe Courtney Cox is 56 years old.
Yeah, I mean.
Well, 75% of her body is.
Still
20.
I don't know what Jennifer Aniston is. I'm curious.
Oh, jeez. The devolution of a podcast.
Yeah, I mean, come on, guys. You know what? We're older now. The people who we were seeing growing up when they were, you know, young and fit aren't that way anymore. Look at your own mortality.
Dennis Quaid.
Yeah, that is definitely a transformation right there.
Yeah.
Dennis Quaid or Randy Quaid?
That's Randy.
I don't care either.
Is that a JoeBlow.com?
Yeah, thing? That's the only picture I can find.
Oh no! I was thinking of Mr. Skin. That's like the logo looks like the same.
Ah.
I was like, "What is Randy Quaid doing on the naked celebrity site?" I want to see Randy
Quaid naked. Oh my god! Oh, I just got an image that I never have in my entire life.
Oh my goodness! Talk about bad Santa.
I don't even know where to go from there.
All right, in other horror news, you guys see that the second season of The Haunting is coming out. The Haunting of Bly Manor coming out in October.
I was going to throw that trailer up, but I have not seen it yet.
Is it the real trailer?
Real trailer, Max.
There is a real trailer, but watch Jason go find a fake one somehow.
I'm waiting for Nick, you know, Jason just bring up a flip book that he just drew real quick.
Here's the trailer.
Scott's still mad about the Avatar one. I'm sorry, Scott.
I'm not mad. I'm just saying it's repeated behavior, you know. And we gotta punish it, or else it's gonna keep happening.
I'm bringing it up with your supervisor. It's gonna be do a write-up sheet.
It's already learned behavior.
So. There's nothing creepier than children saying, "I hate that shit."
The first season was so good.
Yeah, I thought it's hard to end like horror things because I feel give away like a lot of the creepiness.
Yeah.
Oh, here we go.
Either that, or you just make it ridiculous.
But like, anytime you like explain the scare, the spooks, it like kind of undermines the rest of the series, I think. And that's kind of what Hill House did.
This is like American Horror Story, right?
Sort of. I mean, yeah, it's like all the same actors, and it's not gonna be connected to the last season.
Okay.
But I don't think they're trying to like connect them all at some point, like American Horror Story did.
Oh, they tried to make like the American Horrorverse.
Yeah.
Started connecting them a lot lately. Last season was pretty good, but I haven't finished it yet. I'm sure it goes to shit. I always start American Horror Story. I'm like, this one might be good. And then like the last half of the season is like, ugh. Like the first half of the season, the latest one was Slasher. And I loved that. But I haven't gotten past where it stops being a Slasher movie because it always happens.
Yeah. I just know for the first like two seasons, they like really seemed to kill the special needs girl a lot. Problem is, but I think you need to take a long, hard look at yourselves. And the third season where they had that clown in there. I saw like 2 seconds, whatever season that was. I saw 2 seconds of that clown and I was done. Not doing it.
You know, Max, somebody who doesn't like horror, I'm really surprised you watched 2 seasons of American Horror Story.
Yeah, the second season was like good, actually good. The first season I thought was funny. Like I wasn't afraid of it at all. It was just humorous to me. And then the third season was the witches one, right?
Yeah, I like that one. You don't.
Yeah, they also killed the special needs girl in that one.
I think they kill her in all of them.
Yeah, like they're very mean to that poor girl.
I wonder if they brought her back because they did a follow up season where they brought back a lot of the other characters who died in that season, but I don't think she came back.
Yeah, they combined 1 and 3 into a season. I have not finished that one. That one was kind of boring.
I feel like all of them are boring. I know Max peaced out after because the clown thing. I just got really bored with that season. I got like 3 episodes in, or nothing's happening, and I don't care.
Asylum is my best one. I agree with Max.
I really like season 2. I just ditched it after like half the hotel season.
Okay, so you watched the Freak Show and Coven, and then stopped at the hotel.
Wait, I think I missed Freak Show. I started watching Hotel.
Okay. I've been thinking about going back and trying to watch some of the ones I missed, but
good luck.
I want to watch the special. I want to finish that one. So far, it's good, but I know it's going to disappoint me because they all disappoint me. Like the one that they did where they showed like the real events and then they showed the making of the movie based on those events. Mm. Like that was really good until they got to the making the movie of what you just saw. I was not in for that. It had like Cuba Gooding Jr. in it.
Oh jeez.
Oh Cuba. Show me the money.
Missed
that guy.
He's doing big things now.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Gooding, yeah.
Boat Trip.
Boat Trip is a solid flick.
Oh yeah, so good.
That was high quality cinema.
That was one of my favorites.
Oh dude, Ryan's got an evil cat.
Yes.
Nice. Where's Scott's evil cat? You guys have evil cats when you review Star Trek together.
Yeah.
He doesn't like to be held for very long.
They can fight.
I don't know if they want to fight. Christopher Nolan says that he's excited about Robert Pattinson as Batman.
Are you going to say he's excited about
having COVID?
Yeah. I'm like looking at these news stories from last week, and it's like all stuff like that. It's like, yeah.
Who cares? Christopher Nolan.
There's very little actual news. That's the problem.
Oh, yeah. Here we go. We're going to talk about this. We'll watch it first. I forgot this dropped. So let me get this loaded up.
Another fan trailer.
Yeah.
Here we go. Concept City.
You make one mistake on a live show. No, this is on this live show.
Okay.
I did it once on a live show, so I'll calm down. All of the good stuff you've done for the podcast is out the window.
You know, it's easy to judge when you're sitting over here not having to do any of the fucking...
not having to do any of the work.
And I'm going to tell you, it's nice. I like being able to judge you on your failures.
That's why I'm going over to the other side of the desk so he doesn't have to watch me do all the work.
Can we see the Mandalorian trailer again?
You know what? Go to hell.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, this is Max's favorite book.
Yeah. Oh, man. Like, the book is so good. Right up until the end.
Yep.
Max told me to read it, even though the ending's shitty. So yeah. It says a lot
is
about
that Heather Graham?
I don't know.
We'll see how it goes. I wish those guys, who did fucking the Hannibal Lecter show, they should make The Stand.
Ooh, that's a good idea.
I don't know.
To get the Hannibal show back.
Nah, no, Hannibal's done. Like you've gone way too far to come back for that series. But I liked the work they were doing in the beginning, so I feel like if you can get more of that in a Stand show, that would be very good.
The first season was really good. So
yeah.
First two of Hannibal.
Yeah, I'd give it the first two, but you know, it's.
I haven't watched season three because I wanted to save it.
I just hope that they wrote a different ending. I'm gonna watch because I hope that somebody thought of a better ending to this fucking thing.
So the good guys like go to the bad guys camp and just get killed and that's the end.
Yeah, yeah, and the world goes to hell. Sure, why not?
Yeah.
That's a better ending.
Bad guys drop a bomb.
Then the hand of God rises up.
But that's the whole reason, see? Because they went there and they made their stand and then God was pleased.
So he crushed them with his giant hand.
Yes.
Yeah, no. I'm not buying it. That ending sucks. Stephen King, you fucked up on that one, bro. I don't know how else to tell you. The rest of the book was great. Right up till the end.
He just undoes it all at the end, right?
No, it's like, okay.
Yeah.
The literal hand of God comes down
and
kills everyone.
Spoilers, everyone.
And it's like, so what was the fucking point? What was the fucking point?
No, the point was that the good guys...
Out. Huh?
Like the point was that the good guys made their stand at the bad guys' place. And now... With that city gone and everything, they can repopulate, and then Flag can go to Africa and try and redo everything.
Right.
I'm not saying it's a good point. I'm just saying that's the point.
Yeah. So that sucks. And
what the fuck is this? So I'm looking at the trailer page where I got the stand from, and there is a
concept
movie.
Trailer.
No, shut up. There is a movie. Starring DMX called Fast and Fierce.
Well, that sounds great.
I have to see this now. Do you think it's better or worse than Biker Boys?
Better?
I've watched DMX act.
Yeah, that's true.
Who was all right. Biker Boys? Ice Cube, right?
No, Biker Boys was... it had freaking Lawrence Fishburne in it.
Oh, yeah.
Some like black dude. I think Megan Good was in that one.
Derek Luke was then Orlando Jones. Orlando Jones.
Oh, snap.
That's a name.
Make seven up yours. Holy shit.
Wow. We are going to go on our break here in just a second.
And we've got props.
Stay tuned. We got Justin joining us to talk about his podcast and more fun stuff coming up.
Top fives.
right after this break. I have another clip of Max doing things that he's going to probably laugh at. This is the very first interview the Three Geeks podcast ever did.
What?
So everybody have a great break. We'll be back in 5 minutes.
Oh, fucking Michael Rooker. Fuck yeah.
Yeah, I love Michael Rooker.
Oh, I missed that hat, though. Yeah, that was a good hat. Oh, this is terrible. Quality of the recording equipment is obvious. It was like, it was painful for me to watch.
Watch the.
Yeah, like, I look so fat. I look so fat back then.
I like how it went to the video we just did. They can hear us. I'm loading up more commercials. Let everybody else have a few more minutes to do whatever. I got them all done today. I'm so proud.
Yeah, what's with the weird, like, infinite loop we got going on here?
I don't know. That's what I'm going for. Constant showing the same clips over and over and over. I'm just going to start this whole episode over again. That's going to be the second half of the show. Why not? It'll be a blast. I can't wait to talk to our interview. Probably in the next like 5 minutes.
Hey everybody, it's John Orlando from the PVD Cast, and you can catch my podcast over at pvdcast.com, the online home of yours truly, or through any of the major podcasting platforms, and it's even available as a live broadcast every single Monday night at 9:30 through Redline Radio LLC, just go over and check out RedlineRadioLLC.com for more details, and I'll chat at each and every one of you later.
Hi, I'm Casper.
And I'm Becky Gremlin.
And we're the host of Don't Fuck With The Original.
We are a spoopy horror podcast that pretty much covers everything under the genre.
We cover haunted locations, we cover true crime, cryptids, movies, anything you can literally think of. We are all over it.
Everything spoopy.
On Wednesdays, and why?
Wednesdays are for podcast. Thanks, guys.
Fantastic. I love those ladies. I'm glad that I got that done so they could have that advertisement real quick.
Yeah, they're fun people.
People coming up, we're going to be playing Scott and Dan in a remake of Salem's Lot on Remake Revolution in October. You guys ready for that?
No.
Sure. Movie was your idea. I think it was. You picked the movie, right?
That was mine, I think, wasn't it?
Awesome. Fuzzy's still gone, but we have the empty chair that is Ryan.
Yes.
Man.
Nice staging, though. I like it. Oh, hey.
Look back there at the interview that we did with Michael Rooker from who knows how many years ago. You could just see the quality of the show. Just
it's, you know, like, it's really bad. Like, was that somebody's phone? We recorded that on somebody's phone, right?
Probably, or yeah. That camera you had.
Good times.
But it's funny because the interview, I'm watching, I'm like, man, we were doing the interview that we thought we needed to do and not the interview we necessarily wanted to do. Like, we thought we had to do the interview where we talk about the career and blah, 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 blah. Our style of interviewing has definitely changed. And probably for the better because we do them a lot longer than 8 minutes or 3 minutes.
Yeah, and the fucks have been given, so there's zero of those left. Awesome.
I remember that day, man. We were right by the bathroom.
Yeah, that was perfect. Oh, man, that was the best. That was the best
it was perfect.
It was the best spot.
Probably the most traffic we got.
Yeah, you get all the traffic, and you're right next to the bathroom, so when you have to use the bathroom, it's right there.
I mean, the men's restroom at Comic-Con, that's where you want to be.
No.
I mean, don't.
that sounded all wrong, dude.
You want your booth near there.
You want your booth right in front of there.
95% of the people that are there are going to pass you.
Yeah, and that's the ones when they're going in. You want to catch them coming out.
That's right. When they're grosser.
Everyone washes their hands. I'm sure everyone washes their hands.
I don't know, man. The Comic-Con flu says otherwise. My mom was asking me the other day if I thought cons were going to come back. I said, not for a while. I said, can you imagine? Like, the Comic-Con flu was bad. I got it every year except for, I think, the last year we went. Saudi Arabia Comic-Con flu.
Yeah, right?
Who knows what that would have been like? But can you imagine COVID around during a Comic-Con?
The good news is, like, people are down for wearing masks in that community. But the bad news is gatherings of that size just wouldn't be. Yeah, no, it's just not ideal.
I had a nice little combo with Sam Levine at I think it was Origins bathroom.
Do you date with Sam Levine in the bathroom?
What the fuck? That's not at all what I said. No, he and I, like, just, like, randomly bump into each other at cons. And we were, like, just waiting in line at the bathroom because there's, like, a bunch of people filing in. I was like, hey, what's up? He's like, hey, what are you doing? We were just, like, making small talk. I didn't even really know who he was at the time. I'm like, oh, shit. Because I saw him later at his booth. I was like, oh, shit, that's Sam Levine.
Yeah, I got him a cult in Saudi Arabia.
He's a cool guy.
I don't know.
What?
Who has?
Who's got that going on?
I don't know. It's awesome. They sound like fans.
They sound in distress.
Yes.
But yeah, we have to wait for our guests to show up. I started watching iZombie on Netflix.
I dig that show.
I'm liking it so far. It is just like Veronica Mars.
It's very CW. It's just,
if you like Veronica Mars, you will like iZombie. It even has the voiceover, her friend is the black guy that she helps solve crimes with. Like, and it's done racist. By the guy who did Veronica Mars.
Oh, so yeah.
It's very, very Veronica Mars.
Yeah. No, it's.
You like that show?
I enjoyed it. I shouldn't, though. It's a CW show. It's like, I don't know. I watched like maybe a season and a half of it. And like I haven't picked it back up since then.
I'm seeing it.
But like I didn't hate it. Like
I see Max saying I liked it, but I shouldn't have makes me want to watch it more than Jason saying if you like Veronica Mars, you'll like it. Because that to me is like okay, well I'm not gonna watch it. But Max saying like I liked it, but I shouldn't have. I'm like maybe I'll check it out.
I'm just saying it is very if much you, so similar.
If you don't check it out, I don't feel like you're missing. A whole lot.
But I don't if either. You do, if it's not your speed,
it's not your terrible.
Speed. But it is a lot like Veronica Mars. So if you like Veronica Mars, you would like that. If you haven't seen Veronica Mars, you should still check it out.
Never saw Veronica Mars.
What's up, Justin? Yeah. How you doing?
How you guys doing?
Good, man. Welcome to the Three Geeks podcast. Hope you're not easily offended.
Not at all.
No, really.
We'll test that.
Can't you throw that out?
No, I'm just surprised. Yeah. Hope you're not offended. Check out our BB Fish
Nope.
Pod. hey, tell us about your podcasts. You got two that you're doing?
I do have two. The first one I have out right now is called Drunk Conspiracies Podcast. Basically, just how it sounds, I get drunk and I talk conspiracy theories with people.
sounds like a lot of fun.
O'Halloran on yet?
It is. I'm sorry?
Have you had Jack O'Halloran on yet?
I haven't yet.
You gotta ask Steve about Jack. Jack's okay. Stories.
Really?
Yeah,
I'll have to do that because I'm definitely interested in talking with Jack. But yeah, we just get super drunk, talk conspiracy theories. It's a lot of fun. I love it. And my second one, I haven't launched yet, but it's called One on One with Justin Diacima, where I'm interviewing like celebrities, like actors, musicians, athletes, motivational speakers, pretty much anyone. But I'm just about ready to launch that one. I'm just waiting for the artwork to be done.
Nice. How long have you been with Steve?
Not long. Probably maybe going on a month now.
Us too. He's been taking good care of us.
Okay. Yeah, he's got me some interesting people.
Yeah, there's been some very interesting. Like I said, Jack is right up your alley, man. Get him on.
I'm sure he is, yeah.
Now I would like to see Jack drunk talking about the dude some gold sober we were talking about.
Right. Yeah, I'll probably ask him to do my one show and then if he's interested in doing the drunk conspiracy theories one, I'll see if he's up for it, but yeah, that'd be fucking awesome to have him on the drunk conspiracy show.
You should reach out to Randy Quaid. He loves
maybe. Maybe I will.
Jason's just salty because Randy Quaid blocked him.
No shit.
He didn't block me. Like block me. I can still see his Twitter feed. He just blocked me from talking to him. I sent him a message and said, like a day later, said this person no longer accepts messages from you.
I actually got blocked by someone too. I was reaching out to see if they'd come on my one-on-one show, and I'll name drop because I don't really give a fuck. But it was John Gotti Jr. I reached out to see if he'd just come on my show and just talk about his time. Because I'm a big mafia guy. I love the mafia. All about it. And just wanted to see if he'd come on the show. And I sent him a message and everything, reached out. I went back to look. And it like his Instagram was like gone off mine. So I asked my wife, I'm like, hey, will you look up John Gotti Jr. on Instagram? And she pulled it right up. So I got blocked by Gotti Jr. there. So I think it's kind of cool.
It's fun. It's just like it's hard to, you know, be a smaller podcast and try to, you know, get people on and not seem like just, you know, hey, I'm a creepy weirdo. You want to come on my
For game? Sure. Right. But – you know, you win some, you lose some.
For sure.
Well, now we got all this wonderful technology that's like at the forefront because of COVID, like Zoom and StreamYards and everything. That
mm-hmm.
you don't have to invite them to your basement anymore.
Right. That's also true.
Which has really helped us.
Right.
Gotten some awesome guests.
It's so hard to get the people down here, you know? And then, like, come out, tie them up. It's a whole ordeal.
And then they want to leave, you know?
Right?
Right? I'm not like, what's wrong with them?
I'm not going to mention them by name on the podcast, but because I can't remember their name.
Because that would implicate us first.
Yes. They're in the crawl space.
I reached out to one person, and they're like, yeah, she would love to do it. If you can pay her $50 for a half an hour and $100 for an hour. And I'm like, I'm not paying $100 to speak to like somebody that's... who was in like a part five of a horror franchise.
That's almost sex.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. No, yeah. Yeah, I wouldn't do that either.
No. If it was like Keanu Reeves saying, give me $200 to talk to me for an hour, I would have a conversation with her.
Like, for sure.
It wouldn't be a conversation. Yes, you're paying the money. Nope. Like, that's it.
I would take all my money.
Jean-Claude Van Damme's like, I'll come on for five. I wouldn't even ask Max. I'd find the $500 and I'd pay Jean-Claude Van Damme to come talk to me.
I picked it for Jean-Claude Van Damme too, but no, like I'm sorry, random person who we're not paying $50 to, but you're just a little too random for that. You haven't quite made it there yet. I hate to tell you.
No. Nope.
But they actually need the $50, whereas like Jean-Claude Van Damme would.
I mean, you can understand if they're coming on with you guys. It means they're not out there mowing lawns. They got to make up that last income.
So yeah, Justin, tell us more about yourself.
So I right now I live in Michigan.
Ooh, ooh.
Yeah, it's. My whole family's from here. So you guys are from Ohio, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
Oh man. That's tough. any Buckeye fans?
Right here.
Go blue.
The rest of us don't really get
it. No, drop this guy off the podcast.
No, like I'm originally from Tennessee though. But my family's all from Michigan. I live up here now. Met my wife up here. We have a son. He's 5. I just recently started getting into podcasting. I started listening to him about probably 4 months ago now. And then just like kind of took it from there.
Great rep in Ohio right now.
Hold on, I got a Cleveland Indians hat around here.
Sorry, Justin. Continue.
Should I go get my Wolverines hat?
No, don't do that.
Don't worry, nobody's dropping you.
I just cut out all of a sudden.
But anyway, continue. I'm sorry.
Oh, you're good. Yeah, so I just started getting into podcasts, and I got laid off for a little bit from work because of the Corona and all that. So while I was off, I was like, you know what? Now's the perfect time to start up a podcast. Because I was like, if I don't do it now, I'll probably never will. So I just kind of like jumped right into it. So I'm still kind of new, still kind of like get my feet wet and everything. But so far it's going good. I feel like I'm doing pretty decent.
If you want to learn what not to do, you should definitely watch some of Max and Jason's early work.
Well, Max and I actually, our first few episodes were pretty good, but they were edited to crap. And then we decided editing sucks. And then we do everything live. And it took us a while to really learn how to do that.
Now, right.
But one of the best advices I can give anybody who's trying to podcast is just to do it. Like,
yeah.
Grab your microphone, grab your computer, and start doing it. You're not going to be good at first. Just keep at it, and eventually it'll click.
Eventually you'll be mediocre just like us.
Yeah.
Right. Aspire to mediocrity.
We started the podcast with the original goal of having the podcast pay for itself. 6 years later, not even close to there yet.
I'm still owed like $2.
But, it's fun though, and that's the main thing. It's like we just had a bunch of fun, and it's definitely led to a lot of places where I didn't think, you know, we would get to. So like, there's that. It's a lot of fun. Yeah, just keep at it.
Yeah, man.
I will for sure.
Best podcast experience I have is going to Saudi Arabia. I never thought that would happen.
Yeah, that was fucking crazy. Like we sent this dude halfway across the world.
What?
No, we did it. Wizard World did.
Well, yeah, but I mean, that was a freaky podcast, man. Like that's the whole reason you were there.
That's pretty dope.
But I'm not gonna lie. Favorite conspiracy theories.
I'm sorry. What was that?
what's some of your favorite conspiracy theories? Like, I don't Ooh. Constantly seek them out, but sometimes I will go through the YouTube rabbit hole. And then I'll click on the next video, like, oh my god.
Right. Yeah, I mean, there's so many to choose from. Like, because like I definitely keep an open mind on everything. So it's kind of hard to choose like my favorites, but I love talking about like aliens and shit like that. 9/11 is probably one of my favorite conspiracy to talk about. I won't get too deep into it because some people get offended and shit. But 9/11. I just dropped an episode about Jimmy Hoffa on my nice. Show.
You're gonna talk to Jack O'Halloran. That's his jam right there.
Yeah. Jimmy Hoffa,
yeah. JFK and the mob.
Okay, because I live 40 minutes from where Hoffa disappeared. Nice. So like it's literally like right around the corner, and then like the area that I live in, they actually like a few years back started like digging up looking for Hoffa. Just like right down the road from me. And it's crazy to think about like that big of a name and everything, and like living so close to it. It's crazy, but they're never gonna find him. He's not in Michigan anymore.
What would you if they found Jimmy Hoffa in your backyard, like would you freak out just a little bit?
I probably would, but at the same time, I'm pretty sure my podcast would take off from there. Yeah. So like, hey man, if Hoffa's in my backyard, come dig him up. Get him out.
Just buy a tent and start selling tickets.
Running around,
right? Yeah.
They can't kick you out of your own yard.
Exactly. That's true.
So say you do find Hop on the backyard. What souvenir do you take off? What it's probably the skeletal remains.
Oh, for sure. I put it up on the mantle and everything.
Like a do you go like a tooth? Do you like a finger?
Would you take the whole skeleton? Yeah,
the whole skeleton.
They can't take the whole skeleton, then they can't confirm that it's Hoffa. Right,
you know that that's Jimmy Hoffa.
I'll give them a thumb. I'll give them the thumb so they can do whatever they need to identify him. But yeah, I'll put the skull up on the mantle. Then I probably just burn the rest of the body and keep the ashes. Just wear them around my neck.
Yep.
Well, what you could do then is like if somebody's like still throwing around Hoffa conspiracy theories, you'll be like, nope, that's not right. Like, how do you know? Like, I can't tell you.
Let me bring it out.
Like, okay, right?
Just bring the skull out.
Yeah.
That's your new conspiracy meeting. It's you, the Hoffa skull.
Be a new two-man show.
Right?
You can call it Justin and Hoffa.
Hot takes with Hoffa.
Sounds good to me.
Because who's gonna believe that you actually have like the skull?
Right?
Like if Jimmy Hoffa's skull, they'd be like, okay.
Yeah, no one would believe that.
Does it have a certification of letter like that comes with it?
Are you telling me that there's some sort of big conspiracy around you having Jimmy Hoffa's hub? I have a theory about that.
Conspiracy.
Mike asks, where's Mike? Mike is doing big things on McGTV today, but I'll probably be back next week. That was fun.
Mike got tired of John's comments about Asian Americans, so they're pistols at dawn this morning. We're still waiting to hear on the outcome.
This is the first time Mike actually is joining us at Taco Bell. This commercial is not airing.
Oh, thank goodness. Yeah, we already aired the Taco Bell commercial. Okay. Are we going to do the...
Yeah, we'll get to the top five here in a minute. But, Justin, what are your interests? Like, do you have nerdy, geeky interests? Don't get Audible as a sponsor.
Whatever, they're all...
No, we went to a con. Like, everybody in the audience had Audible as a sponsor.
Okay. So do not go with Audible.
Don't. Try to get Manscaped.
Okay. I'll reach out to him and be like, look, sponsor me.
Like, we get drunk. We talk about Jimmy Hoffa. I need a sponsor.
Yeah. Why not? It's a perfect fit.
I'm sold. You know, if I had the money, I'd give it to you right now.
I appreciate it. But no, my interest, me and my wife, we go to Comic-Con every year up here in Michigan. It's one of my favorite things to do. I mainly go for like a bunch of the artwork. Like, I just like love the fucking artwork they do and stuff like that. I'm big into horror films and stuff like that. So a lot of the artwork I buy is like horror related and shit like that. I'm a big Batman. My favorite horror film, Halloween, hands down.
Solid choice.
Except for Rob Zombies.
What did you think of the new
also
one?
Also solid.
I loved the new one. The new one was good. I loved the new one. I loved how aggressive they made Michael. Like, every kill he did was just so fucking aggressive, and I loved it. But yeah, fuck Rob Zombie for that shit.
I like the Devil's Rejects.
Yeah, his own movies were fine. I don't mind his movies, but when he tried to remake Halloween, man, it was totally different than the original. He made Michael run. Michael doesn't run. Like, and then in the second one, he has flashbacks of a fucking pony. Like,
yeah, the pony was weird.
You got this badass motherfucking killer, like, seeing himself, his mom, and a fucking pony. Like, come on. Like,
what is this, Blade Runner?
I don't, right.
Yeah.
It was horrible. He's a robot. But hands down, definitely Halloween's my favorite horror movie and franchise of all time.
Yeah, I think that's one of my favorite franchises too.
I started watching it when I was three. Like, I was three the first time I watched Halloween. Which I probably sounds kind of bad.
Definitely bad.
But my son watched it. My son watched it with me when he was four, so about a year ago.
You see, that's the appropriate time to wait.
To be honest, he wasn't scared, but now all of a sudden he won't watch it now. I don't know if he had a dream. I don't know if my wife put it in his head, because my wife's like, you shouldn't be watching this with him. I was like, babe, I was like 3 years old when I first started. He's four. He has a year on me. Like, yeah, it's fine. But I don't know. But he knows who Michael is. Like, we'll go to the Halloween store and he'll point out Michael Myers. He's like, look, daddy, it's Michael. And he points out Chucky, points out Sam from the Trick or Treat movie. He's super into Halloween and shit. So I'm happy father moment there. But yeah, it's crazy.
Nice. That's my question. Max, you got some questions?
I was just hanging. I thought we were just hanging out with another fellow podcaster.
We are.
I didn't prepare anything. What's Michigan like as far as just like life? You know, I know you got laid off from your job, but you know, how are you guys doing as far as just like getting around and being around? Do you mostly stay inside, or are you? Yeah. What are your levels like? Are you guys doing good or bad? Like, how's living right now?
Living's all right. I'm actually back at work now. My wife was at work this whole time. She never got break. She found out though that she likes having a stay at home husband. So once she can make us some more money, I can stay at home with our son. I guess that's the end goal there. But and then I can work on my podcast more. But yeah, other than that, living's good. We still got to wear the masks and shit. Still like the social distancing, just like everyone else. But yeah, Michigan was like one of the worst states that like it, like we took it like very serious. Like we like shut down. I don't know how much Ohio, if you guys shut down as much as us, but like
we shut down a little bit.
Okay. But not like Michigan. Minute.
Yeah, no, definitely not. I think you guys are definitely a little harsher. But I mean, like, I think it was more locked down in like bigger city, like Cleveland area was more locked down, and Columbus was kind of locked down. I think Cincinnati was a little more locked down, but it wasn't the harshest of
no, it, we got it pretty bad. Our governor even just extended everything, so like we're still going. And so yeah, but other than that, everything's fine. We still go and do some shit. still take my son outside to the playground and shit like that. So, I mean, we can't do everything that we were doing before, but we can, we still get out there and do quite a bit. I know it's messed up because of the pandemic and everything, but we went down to Myrtle Beach. We took a vacation and, they weren't going to give me my refund back. So I was just like, all right, I'm going to be there then. Like, they pretty much told me, they're like, cause we weren't going to go. And they're like, if you don't show up, you're just out your money. And I'm like, all right, I'll be there. Like, I'm going to go. So, but
well, I mean, you made it, so all's well that ends well.
Yeah, we're good.
I had a similar situation. We had to go to Myrtle Beach and use our stuff before they kept our money. So we did.
Yeah.
No COVID for us. They seem to be doing things all right down there, though.
They seem all right. Yeah. I know once they reopen, I know the numbers kind of went up again. But we were fine. We didn't get it. We also took a trip down to Tennessee where I grew up and where I was from. So I was able to show my wife and kid where I lived. And same thing with them. Their numbers kind of went up a little more too, but we didn't catch anything. So we're good.
Awesome. Let's start a top five Disney animated movies.
Top five.
Not Pixar.
All right.
Because if we included Pixar, it'd be all of my top five except for one.
I had like three or four in my top from Pixar, so. But no, I think I got a good list here.
All right, let's start with you. Your number five.
My number five. Can I do an honorable mention because number five and this one were kind of neck and neck for me? Absolutely. So my honorable mention would be Zootopia.
That's a good one.
I don't know if you guys seen it or not.
I love that movie. No, that's great. I think Dan's got that on his list.
Okay.
Five, Dan?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So hold off on Zootopia. Okay. What's the other one?
So my number five would be Moana.
Hey!
I forgot. See, my kids are older, so when I do get to watch these, I don't have to watch them over and over again, so they don't really get annoying.
Oh, yeah. See, I watch it, like, constantly over, just not, like, on repeat. Watch it, like, four times, and then my son will pick a new one to watch four times, and then another one.
I remember those times.
Yeah. So, I got Moana at number five.
Okay.
Scott, do you have Moana at the same place?
Yeah, actually. My honorable mention... But I guess we won't worry about that. But yeah, Moana is my number five. It was very close to getting replaced with my honorable mention, which I guess we'll wait.
Okay.
But yeah, Moana is my number five as well.
Okay.
What?
Is Zootopia your honorable mention as well?
No.
That would have been weird.
You guys are best friends.
The rocks was the most surprising part of Moana. Like,
yeah.
I'm not going to say he's the greatest singer in the world, but the song that he did or the songs that he was a part of, they played to his strengths.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Very surprising.
Definitely showed his range.
Yes. My number five is Nightmare Before Christmas.
Which there was some contention about whether we made the list, but we decided to let it in at the last minute.
Yeah, there's a whole 10-minute argument prior to the podcast.
But we can all agree that Nightmare Before Christmas is better than any Winnie the Pooh movie, so that's why we let that.
True.
Nightmare Before Christmas. Just calm down right now.
Jesus Christ.
Do not get ahead of yourself, Max. Fuck you for assuming. Yeah, no, Winnie the Pooh's right there representing. But,
Nightmare Before Christmas. That's a solid flick.
That is a good movie.
I agree.
It's both. It's both. You can watch it.
Yeah, I'd agree. Because you go into a Halloween store, you got a bunch of Nightmare Before Christmas shit. And then even at Christmas time, I see stuff for it. So, yeah.
Right. It's both. But a lot of people argue for no reason.
You see, like, yeah, like I'm a lot of put an or in places where it should just be an and.
Yeah, people just like talking about what's a Christmas movie and what's not. If Christmas is central to the plot, it is a Christmas movie. Like Die Hard. Like Don McLean is only there because it's Christmas.
Yep.
Die Hard is a Christmas movie.
I think everyone's in agreement.
You take Christmas out of Die Hard.
Makes no sense.
There's no movie.
No one's going to go visit.
Exactly.
Die Hard is my number one animated Disney movie.
Yeah. Well, followed by Sadly Night, or Silent Night, Deadly Night.
Now that Disney owns Fox, I'd love for him to do the opposite and remake it as an animated movie.
No.
I'm going to go watch the Die Hard animated movie. I'm down.
I would too, for sure.
Yeah, charge her $30 for that in December.
It's going to be so awful.
Man, too soon, Dan. Too soon. Nah. Fuzzy, what's your number five?
My number five, I'm going way far back, and I actually just rewatched this with my son. We're going Sword in the Stone.
Ooh.
Wow.
I haven't seen that. Is on my list, sir.
Okay, so it's higher on Dan's list. All right, we'll put that on the shelf for right now. My number five was DuckTales, Treasure of the Lost Land.
Nice. Honorable mention.
Yeah.
All right, that's going to be my number four. Taking one of the B2 movies off?
Bullshit. No, that is bullshit. DuckTales, Treasure of the Lost Lamp is one of my favorite animated movies. I used to watch it all the time when I was a kid. It's just very well done. It still holds up, and yeah, I really like it.
It's good stuff. Absolutely good stuff. Oh my god, I forgot about this. It's on my damn show.
But it's not on your list, so that's fine. No, it's not. It's not. That's bullshit. Yeah. That's bullshit.
You said too many.
No, you don't get to change your list right now because of my pick. That's not fair.
You can always change your list. The list is there until I say
bullshit.
It.
All right, I'm just going to see if or I'm going to have to make another caveat to my. Did anyone else have any of my picks? I'm trying to go unshared with the pick, so this doesn't count. Pre podcast, did anyone have the same shit? That's what I'm going by. I'm still clean and clear.
That's fair. You brought it to my attention. That's a good friend. I did forget about it.
Oh, like man. No, that movie is great.
If you forgot about it, it's not on your list.
I'm disappointed. I'm a horrible fan. David, what is your number five?
Are we adding Touchstone to this or not?
Yes.
Yeah.
It's part of Disney. It's just Pixar.
We're going to let
Pixar
movies.
Who Framed Roger Rabbit? Not that entirely animated, but it's got enough. Come on.
That counts. It follows Animaniacs rules. That counts.
It gives us Donald and Daffy Duck together. It's one of my favorite scenes from the movie.
I don't understand.
It's an awesome flick, and nobody's not seen this, right? So you all know it's an awesome flick.
Yeah, true.
Oh, my God. That's a good one, Dan. I'm not adding it to my list, but that is definitely.
You better not. JT's list is just completely plagiarized. Everyone.
He's like dude in the Italian Job, Ed Norton in the Italian Job. He's like, yeah, I'll just have one of what you guys do.
Number fours.
What's that?
Number fours.
Yep, Justin. What's your number four?
My number four is Big Hero 6.
Oh, okay. That's higher on my list. You got to put it on the shelf. Shit.
Yeah, that's higher on my list too. I wasn't sure if anyone else is gonna pick that.
Me neither. Yeah. We'll talk about it. We'll talk about it later.
All right.
Good pick, Justin. Yeah. Good pick.
Thank you.
My number four was DuckTales.
Sure, it was. Sure.
All right. Moving on, Scott. What was your number four?
So my number four is Zootopia. I don't know where it's at on anybody else's list, but if we want to talk about it now.
Is it higher on your list, Dan?
Which one?
Zootopia is my number four.
It's going to be four. So.
Okay, so yeah. So we can talk about it. Yeah.
Yeah.
I like this movie a lot. It does.
Yeah, me too.
I can see the emotional impact it's had on you.
It's happy. It hits you in the feels several times, and I like the scary predator animals. They make me happy.
Zootopia came out at a very dark point in my life. Batman versus Superman had come out like maybe a month before that movie, and I was that's how I felt, Fuzzy. That's how I felt.
Like, ugh, fuck Martha.
But Zootopia came, and it's just like sheer unbridled happiness in a bottle, and I needed that very much. I that movie holds a special. It got me out of a dark place in my life.
I think it has a lot of good allegories, I guess, for like stuff that's still going on today. Like, there's a lot of stuff about like xenophobia and classism and racism and stuff like that. So, still mm-hmm. Some very good messages.
Yeah, I think one of my favorite like scenes out of there when they were like tearing through the little mouse town.
The sloths. Like giants running through this tiny little town.
How perfect is it having the sloths in the DMV? Like,
that's my favorite.
To real life.
That's my favorite part of that movie.
And then the sloth gets pulled over for speeding at the end.
Well crafted.
It pays off. Because it does seem just like kind of like a trailer. Like, it was in all the trailers. So it's like, oh, this is just a trailer moment. Most of the time, like when stuff like that happens, like when it happens in the movie, I just gloss over. Like, I've seen this. But the fact that, there's that little payoff right at the end, like, it's like, okay. It wasn't just like, let's make this, and it's going to go in the trailer. The end.
Fuzzy, what is happening?
We're like, what are you doing? Leave that poor cat alone. Ow, someone called the ASPCA.
Fuzzy, what's your number four?
My number four is Atlantis, The Lost Empire.
Ooh. Nice. That is a sneaky good one. I like that one.
Yeah. I forgot about that movie.
I like that explosions dude in that movie.
It is. It has a very nice cast of characters there. It has betrayal. It has sci-fi. It has weird god stone thingies. Michael J. Fox. Who doesn't love Michael J. Fox?
Right? Done. Yeah. Sold.
Yeah.
Dude, Michael J. Fox is an American treasure.
Yeah.
I just watched The Frighteners with him. That was nice. A funny, good movie.
Mm-hmm. I was wondering if you liked it. I didn't even ask you.
No, I dug it for sure. I liked it a lot.
It's like one of Peter Jackson's first movies.
Huh.
Well,
Number four for me goes to the Rescuers franchise. Mostly the Rescuers Down Under, oddly. I love that movie. That's another one I watched 800 times when I was a kid. There's a third one?
No, that's my number three. Is Rescue Down Under. Number three.
Okay, all right, I'll mix it then. That was my number four. Justin, what's your number four?
We did
mine. Yeah,
my fault.
You're good.
And
no, mine was Zootopia. We already get it.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, we tied on that one.
We did one, Justin. It's the wrong number.
Yeah.
Justin, what's your number three?
My number three is Aladdin.
I'll save it. Yeah.
Jeez. This is the best podcast to be on. This is
Sam, I'm having a great time.
My number three was Many Adventures of Winnie the Pooh. The original one. I originally had the Winnie the Pooh from a few years ago, where Zoe Deschanel did the song, but this is the one.
What are like? Cause isn't that like a? It's got a bunch of like shorts in it.
Yeah, it's the one. So, it's 1977. It's the one that started it all, based on the books. It's the one where Pooh gets stuck in the hole.
You mean Winnie the Pooh and the Honey Tree?
Yeah.
Doesn't that happen every time?
Yeah. Okay. So it's Honey Tree, Blustery Day, and Winnie the Pooh and Tigger too. Yeah, I watched that one a shit ton as a kid.
It's
pre
Jim Cummings. Sterling Holloway was the voice of Winnie the Pooh in that one.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. I don't know this off the top of my head. I have Google.
Yeah, you just let people.
Yeah, it's fine.
Pretend with you and type completely acknowledge of Winnie the Pooh.
Scott, what's your number three?
My number three is Big Hero 6.
Still higher on the list. So.
Still higher on the list? All right, well, keep going then.
I know we're all in anticipation to find out what Ryan's number three is, but Fuzzy, what's your number three?
You know, my number three is Rescues Down Under.
That's I don't know why I love that fucking movie. The dude singing "Home on the Range" is just
it's a great villain. I mean, it's great. I mean, it's what is it? The Albatross. Oh.
Yeah.
Miss Bianca. My daughter's name is Bianca.
Oh, yeah.
Great flick. And it helped that growing up, that was one of the few VHSs we had. So we got to watch it a bunch of times. But, oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. And watching the first one and the second one, I don't know why. I mean, like, they're basically the same. But, like, you know, I think the villain is just better, resonates with me more. Yeah. The rest
of place in Australia.
Yeah, who doesn't love a trip down on that?
Apparently there's a fan fiction for Rescuers 3.
Oh, I don't know.
Another fan that could have ended it. Piece of media.
I called it as it was, and I'm not reading the script, Scott.
Hey, throw up the trailer, JT.
You never know. A lot of people don't know this, but they released a trailer for Dumbo 2 on one of the VHS tapes from the early 2000s, but they never actually released Dumbo 2. It got scrapped because I guess it was really bad. Like, yes. I can't imagine how bad it was after seeing some of the Disney sequels.
But right? Like, I just watched Mulan. Like, it couldn't have been worse than that.
No, probably not.
Maybe they doubled down on the crows.
Mm. Dude, I love Jim Crow.
Max,
it's like, I love that it's just like they won't show Song in the South on Disney Plus, but they still have Dumbo. And last time I watched it, they didn't. I don't think they had a disclaimer in front of it.
Yeah, you know, whatever. Racist.
And you got all the black guys singing at the beginning. We never learn to read or write. We work all day. We work all night. Like it's just like so. Like, I love the racism in that movie.
Dumbo!
Oh my god, I just watched that. I must have muted that all out.
It's so awesome. I love, because then you've got like everything with James Gunn, but they're just like showing Dumbo unedited on Disney Plus.
Added a disclaimer, Scott.
Oh man.
Okay, right, I am not racist, but I love when companies do horrible things and then call other people out on doing like horrible things.
Hypocrisy is
perfect. Especially a big horrible conglomerate like Disney.
Yeah.
It's amazing. I love it.
Yeah, but it's an animated character saying it, not a real person.
Right. No, it's a crow. It's not. Anyway.
So what if, all right, real last thought. Last thought. What if, like, when they had, it's like they probably got white people to voice all that, but what if they had them do blackface in the booth? You think, like, I could see Disney doing geez. That.
They're just getting into character.
You know, like the method voice actor.
Oh, God.
But you know what, though? Like, at least that's not like, you're going to the booth, you're like, it's not like, you're not out in public with the blackface on. Don't do it regardless, but I guess if you have to, it's best done in the vocal studio versus.
What if they had to get the ambiance down? So they just wandered outside.
TMZ. my number three is a goofy movie.
Oh, it's a good one.
No,
save it.
Oh, okay.
This might be a hot take. I don't like the Goofy movie.
The Leaning Tower of Cheese. It's like Really Short Day that anybody cared about.
All right, we're moving. All right, who hasn't done the number three yet? Dan?
Sword in the Stone.
Okay.
Now, I've seen it recently, and I like that it's all cleaned up, but I loved it when I was a kid. And nostalgia doesn't quite hold up, but I'm still throwing it on here because I watch this VHS over and over and over again.
That's fair. It was absolutely
fair. Yeah, it was both this and Robin Hood, but I like this one better. So.
Cool. Yeah, so I kind of put them like right there the same too.
We'll get into some of our honorable mentions because there's quite a few for me after this. But Justin, what was your three?
We did mine.
Yeah,
we did Aladdin.
Two.
Or yeah. My two. My number two is The Lion King.
You see, like, that's be my number two. I have those two in also. Like,
yeah.
That's my number two.
Actually, no, I think I like Aladdin. I flip them, but they're right there next to each other.
I was going back and forth with them on which Aladdin, one I liked better.
Mm-hmm.
Aladdin is my number two. I sang "Can You Feel the Love Tonight" to a girl in sixth grade trying to date me.
And how'd that go?
How'd that work?
Yeah. Very well. We dated seven times after that. Her name was Tracy. She's a frequent listener of the podcast. It became a joke after a while where we would ask each other out because we dated like 4 years in a row, but not like consistently like that whole time. So we would just ask each other out and then break up with each other like 30 seconds later. Just keep
young love.
Young love. I was a good singer. Still not a good singer. So you can imagine how horrible that was. Followed Boys to Men. I did that too for her. But The Lion King's great. Elton John soundtrack is... I can't imagine that movie without Elton John.
Right.
Yeah, no, it was good. I dig The Lion King. It came out at the right time for me. You know, like Aladdin and Lion King, I think came out. Those are the like two back to back, and like Lion King like advanced the industry. So there was a lot. But you know, like, yeah, those are definitely solid flicks.
Max's family took me to see that. Good stuff. We went to McDonald's first. You don't remember it, do you?
No.
Went to Toys R Us, and then I went. We got my little Crypt Keeper animated toy there. It was great. And then we went to see Lion King. And I didn't want to see this movie, but it's great.
Jason had a way better experience than I did.
Did you see the live action remake?
It's not a live action remake. It's
better
all animated.
Yeah.
It's the animated to look like live action remake. There. That's
okay, but it's still not live action.
Remake. Photorealistic remake.
I've not seen it either. I'm afraid.
I heard horrible things about it, and I don't want it to ruin The Lion King for me, so I put a pause on watching it.
That's fair. I'm still going to watch it eventually. It's just not on my list.
I will eventually, but I'll take my sweet-ass time.
Scott, what's your number two?
All right, so my number two... And I'm really hoping nobody else got this on their list, is The Great Mouse Detective.
Nice.
Oh, okay.
I think this might be the first pick from anybody, except for Jason's Winnie the Pooh. It wasn't there.
Was not on anyone else's list.
That's fair. Well, no, it was retroactively on Jason's, so.
Roger Rabbit.
Max still gets credit for not being bullshit on his list.
Fucking... Touchstone doesn't count. I still don't count. Touchstone counts. But yeah, Great Mouse Detective, it's great. I actually haven't seen it in a while, but I saw it like semi-recently. Like, I've seen it this year, and you know, it still holds up really well. So. It's a real fun movie.
Nice. It's based on Sherlock Holmes, right?
It is.
I have not seen it.
It's on Disney Plus. Go check it out.
I will check it out. I think it's in my Disney Plus, too. Fuzzy, what's your number two?
My number two is The Emperor's New Groove.
Really?
Really?
Okay. I'm shocked.
That was actually very close to being my number two as well.
Really?
Yeah.
It wasn't even on your list. It was number two.
But it's one of those movies where I'm like, I like it a lot, but like, I don't, you know, I don't know how to explain it. You're like, oh, this could be my number two, but it wouldn't really like go anywhere else on the list. Like, you know,
genuinely enjoy the story, all the characters, it's really
John Goodman.
The guy does the voice of John Goodman. The guy does the voice of Brock, who I can't think about from what is it? Venture Brothers.
Oh, Brock Sampson.
Brock Sampson voice. Yeah.
Nice.
What is that guy's name? Joe from Family Guy.
I don't know the guy's name either.
Yeah, yeah.
A very distinctive voice.
Patrick Warburton.
Yes.
Buddy from Seinfeld.
Yes. My number two is Big Hero 6. I didn't realize that this was a Marvel franchise before they made the movie. So like they really kind of took it and did their own thing with it. But I mean, I'm a sucker for a good robot. It's superheroes and animation, so it's like got all my good things. I really, really dug Big Hero 6. And then I actually went back and read the comic book afterwards, and it is hilariously nothing like the movie. So it's awesome. It works on a bunch of levels for me. Like I thought it was a really, really good movie.
It's got the second best Stan Lee animated cameo.
Yes.
Yeah.
The first being Teen Titans Go, Stan Lee's cameo on that. Nothing else.
Big Hero 6.
Yeah, I had it at my number 4, and I just remember the first time I watched it with my son. Like, it was just a phenomenal movie, and like super fucking sad too, man. I was just like, this is a kid's movie. I'm like, yep. I'm about to start crying. I'm a 30-year-old man. Like, but no, it was just well done, and it was a great storyline, great characters, and yeah, that's why it definitely made my top 5 favorite Disney movie, animated movie.
Big Hero 6 is in that class with Frozen and Moana, where
mm-hmm.
they the right lessons from Pixar when they made these movies.
Mm-hmm. Right. I agree.
Did somebody else have Big Hero 6 on their list?
Yeah, mine was 3.
Oh, okay. So 2, 3, and 4? That's...
Yeah.
Covers almost every number.
Who? What? What did you say?
I don't know. Is it my turn?
Yes.
Yeah.
Treasure Planet.
Oh, honorable mentions. Yes, absolutely.
I really like that one a lot. I like the background. I like that he's flying around, and it doesn't help that Treasure Island is one of my favorite classic books. So there you go.
I think that keeps me from liking it a lot because I really like Treasure Island, and I don't know. It's one of those movies. I feel like I really liked it the first time I watched it, and then I liked it less every time every subsequent watch through.
What was I going to say? No, Treasure Planet for me is like that problem that Scott was having, where it's like, yeah, it would be like number 3, but I can't replace my number 3 movie with that, and it doesn't work anywhere else on the list. Treasure Planet, I love it. That's a good one too.
This is another one I have not seen.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh well, that one slipped by a lot of people. I think. It didn't get a lot of love in the theaters either.
I haven't seen it since I was a kid. So,
I guess I don't hate it. It's just one of those things. I was just like, I really like this, and I was like, yeah, it's fine.
Yeah, apparently, I was a kid.
Yeah,
one of the first things that I watched when I signed up for Disney Plus. So, I was like, oh, sweet. That and a Return to Oz.
First thing I did when I signed up for Disney Plus was look for Song of the South.
Yeah, no. You're not getting that, dude. You got to find that kid on VHS.
I have it on Blu-ray. I have not had, the stomach to watch it yet, but I do know it. Justin, what's your number one?
My number one is a Goofy movie.
Goofy movie nice. Is so solid. Like, I mean, it tickles me because, like, me and my dad went and my brother went on road trips on spring break, a few years in a row. So, like, it's got all that family stuff in there. It's got way more heart than I think it, like, had right to. And I really dug that movie.
Yeah, super underrated. I looked up the numbers, the top 5 movies that I picked. I looked at all the numbers it did, like box office and all that. And this definitely did the worst out of all the movies. But, I mean, I don't know. It's got a lot of heart to me. I loved it as a kid. I love it now. It's just definitely my favorite Disney animated
movie. That's fair. I love Goofy. Parts, and Goofy's one of my favorite parts.
Well, I mean, I liked Goof Troop. You know, I really love Goof Troop.
Yeah,
and it was like they made a Goof Troop movie, and I was like, okay, like I'm down. Like, and it was just really good. Like, it was way better than I thought it was going to be. I have a Powerline concert tour T-shirt. Like,
that's awesome.
I bought that for him. I was thinking of him.
Yeah. So no, for sure.
Yeah, great movie. Yeah.
My number one is, I mean, this is the only place this movie should be. Prince Ali, yes it is he. Me and my friend Amit would go to sleep listening to the soundtrack on the slumber parties. Like, this movie, I even like the remake. Will Smith is no Robin Williams, but I thought the remake had a bunch of heart and charm that the original had. But I love this movie. I love everything about this movie. I could watch this movie right now, not be bored. I love this movie so much that I even like the sequels that are far lesser. We get the voice of Homer Simpson replacing Robin Williams in the second. And then Robin Williams comes back for the third movie. So the third movie is slightly better than two. But I love them all.
You know, it's King of Thieves or Prince of Thieves? And then Return of Jafar.
Return of Jafar, and then it is...
I think it was King of Thieves.
I could hold on a second.
And the King of Thieves.
It is...
Yeah, it's King of Thieves. King of Thieves.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Yeah, I agree too. Like that was like is watchable. Other than like Return of Jafar wasn't terrible. I think you get a lot more of Gilbert Gottfried in that one, which I dig. But yeah, I think King of Thieves was a little better than Return of Jafar.
Well, real quick, tangent. Did anybody hear Gilbert Gottfried's version of WAP?
No, that I want to hear.
If we have time, maybe we'll react to it.
Oh, maybe we'll see the fan movie of
it's a Gilbert Gottfried impersonator.
Yeah.
You know what, Scott?
All right. Stop the
video. Wearing the Mandalorian armor. Time
out. Oh.
Who's next? Scott's
next. All right. So my number one is Robin Hood. I absolutely love this movie. It's easily my favorite, like Disney animated, like of any of the Disney animated. If we're going like old school animation, this is easily my favorite. I love Aladdin and Lion King and all those other ones too. But this is probably the one I watched the most as a kid.
For the longest time, like, this was the Robin, like, when I thought of Robin Hood, like, this movie was, like, what I thought about. Like, I feel you on that.
What do you think of as Robin Hood now? Cary Elwes or Kevin Costner?
I'd say more Cary Elwes than Kevin Costner.
Or do you think of Russell Crowe?
No, I never even saw the Russell Crowe one.
Russell
Crowe. Yeah, I never did either.
Don't.
I did. It's not good.
Do it. No, it's not.
I don't know. Who's the guy who did Men in Tights?
Cary Elwes.
Cary Elwes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. No, Men in Tights is the best Robin Hood.
Yeah.
Mel Brooks.
I kind of have to go with Prince of Thieves.
Kevin Costner.
Yeah, but the Sheriff of Nottingham.
Later. The only issue I have with Kevin Costner movies is they're so long. They're all so long. They said he was making a TV show. I'm like, that makes perfect sense. Like, Kevin Costner, I mean, on television.
To be fair, like Robin Hood isn't like Open Range, okay?
Open Range is a good movie.
It's a long ass movie, I'll tell you that.
Yeah, but good.
Yeah, man, Robin Hood, that's a good choice, Scott.
Mm-hmm.
Not Aladdin, but it's still a good
I mean, everyone's got their own preferences.
What's your number two?
Number one.
Number one.
Number one would have to be Lilo and Stitch.
Yeah. What do you think of the live-action movie they're making of that coming out soon?
Oh, God.
I don't know. Maybe I'll watch it on mute. I mean, there's no songs in the original, so there's no songs for them to wish for, but for them to, you know, change slightly so they can include dancing. But I said, well, if they do a good job, why not?
Oh, man. Mulan does not give me great faith in their ability to adapt their own shit. I mean, come on!
Like I said, the best one is Cinderella. But Bryony Lau asks, what that logo is in the this upper right hand corner.
Oh, I'm not on top anymore.
Brian Lau, that is the lovely logo that you made for us. And if anybody is watching us now, check out Staunch Ambition. Just go to Staunch Ambition on all the social medias and it'll lead you right to his website. And I believe it's staunchambition.com.
Get ready for some trippy art.
But, Max, your number one?
Number one for me goes to The Incredibles. You're talking about Disney taking all the right lessons from Pixar. I think they knocked it out of the fucking park with Incredibles. The greatest Fantastic Four story ever told. I love it. It's so good. I love the characters. Again, I'm a sucker for superheroes and animation. So they got me on all counts. And it's just a great story. There's a lot of dark moments. There's a lot of heart. And I mean, like I Incredibles 2, I enjoyed, but not as much as his first one. Just because it didn't bring that heart with it. But I love the Incredibles. It's my favorite franchise, Disney franchise, hands down.
You said Disney learned a lot from Pixar making the Incredibles.
Yeah,
it's a Pixar movie, though.
It's a Pixar movie. Yeah,
it's a Disney movie. That was when Disney bought.
Now,
if you have one Pixar on your list, I'm fine with that. As long as it's not Pixar
dominated. It was on the Disney list. That's the only reason.
They own Pixar. The only reason I left Pixar off is because they would have been all five of my choices, except for my choices. So,
but no, I mean, like the Pixar movies are good. Like Toy Stories are good, and like Monsters Inc. And like, but they're not my favorites. Like,
see, I would have put Monsters Inc. and I would have done the first three Toy Stories and Aladdin.
I
would have had Toy Story. And I wasn't a big fan of Monsters Inc.
Toy Story 1 is the best movie. Toy Story 2 is the second best. Like the Toy Story franchise is number one. You're like, that's what you do. Like,
yeah.
What is going on?
My son keeps falling asleep on me.
Damn, what's your number one?
I'm going to go with The Adventures of Ichabod and Mr. Toad.
That's
a good one.
Okay.
I had the VHS for this, and at a yard sale last year, I found the VHS again. I've been trying to get these guys to watch it for Animaniacs, but they're like, no, can't have VHS movies.
We're not doing that. No, we're not.
It's fascinating that none of us chose Fantasia.
Fuck Fantasia.
Yeah,
Like, it's just like a bunch of like shorts stitched together with music. Like, I don't know. It's not like, oh, this is a great central plot.
Yeah, I mean, one of my honorable mentions was Oliver and Company.
Yeah, mine too.
Okay.
That was back in the days, children. Movies didn't always come out on VHS after they aired in movie theaters, and Oliver and Company was one of them. They didn't release that the home video until many, many, many years after I saw it in the theater. They gave us the one song, like they did Zippity Doodah after they shelved Song of the South, but that's all I had. And then when it finally came out on DVD and then Blu-ray, I was really excited and bought it. I bought it for Kylie, who wasn't born yet, so she could watch it. And I was afraid they were going to take it away from me again.
Jungle Book, honorable mention.
Good movie.
Mm-hmm.
My honorable mention is Wreck-It Ralph.
That's a good one.
I like both of them too. Yeah, I like both of them. They're doing pretty good. I mean, John C. Reilly, you gotta love that dude. I can't get enough John C. Reilly. So whatever he's doing, I'm at least down to give a shot. But I thought Wreck-It Ralph was. I mean, because like you get to see a lot of your awesome like old school video game characters. That you know they get a lot of like nostalgia off the rip for that. And and the movie was solid. And like basically. They're like 2/3 of the movie happens in Mario Kart. So how can I be like
that? So I actually went to the BMV. I had to get my like you know the new license where you need like all the new documentation. I guess this was last year when they put up Ralph Breaks the Internet, and I saw the entire movie waiting at the BMV. Nice. I'd already seen it, but I was like, I wonder how far into this movie I'll get. And we got through the entire movie.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Terrible.
Yeah. It wasn't even that crowded, too, which is, like, the depressing part. Like, once I finally got up there, I was like, here's all my documents. All right, take your picture. Like, I was in and out in, like, 10 minutes.
Yeah.
But, like, everybody else was like, oh, what do I need? Oh, what do I have to do?
You save my place in line? Yeah. honorable mention for me would be the Black Cauldron, because I like what they do with the bad guys. Okay,
my favorite part
guys
is
are all idiots.
It kills itself.
You can tell that Brian E. Lau was not listening to the whole. It was not here for the whole cast.
Really?
Because the Emperor's New Groove made the list, bro. So
it was Brian's number one.
No, mine number two.
It was number two.
So yeah, no, we did mention. That one escapes me. I'm not a very big fan of The Emperor's New Groove, but cool.
Nobody's perfect, Max.
Maybe I need to watch it again.
But our Disney segment was sponsored by... I'm just kidding, I'm not going to play it.
No.
I can only play it once per episode where they yell at me.
Even that's too much.
Yeah, even that's too much. You got to shelve it for like a month and then bring it back. And then you get that little bit of the nostalgia feel. If you hit us with it every time, it doesn't work.
Dude, yeah, here's a blast from the past. I brought this back.
Oh, hey, okay.
Gotta go, guys.
All right. Well, we're ending the show right now.
Thank you
for tuning in. Justin, tell everybody where they can find you.
You can find me on Instagram at Drunk Conspiracies Podcast. Also on Instagram for one-on-one JD. It couldn't fit my whole name in there. It was too long. So one-on-one JD on Instagram, and then Drunk Conspiracies Podcast on Instagram. I made a Twitter for my Drunk Conspiracies, but fuck that. Like no one does Twitter. So I'm not even going to do that. I have a page on Facebook, Drunk Conspiracies Podcast. But yeah, I'm on Apple, Spotify, and Google Podcasts.
Awesome, Justin. Thank you for coming on, dude. Great to meet you. We're going to have you on again, or maybe we can get drunk and I can talk some conspiracies with you.
That'd be awesome. Yeah, and anytime, I'd love to come back on. I'd love to have you guys on my show. We can get drunk and talk conspiracies anytime.
Awesome. All right, dude.
All the links to Justin's stuff is in the description of this video or this audio. So click it, enjoy it, check it out. And for all of us at Three Geeks Podcast, have a great day, even though we're going to continue to talk about the credits.
And recycle your droids. I like this credit wash thing that you got going on here. It's fun.
It's like Saved by the Bell kind of thing going on.
Yeah, that's exactly the feel, Dan. That's perfect.
It needs like more triangles.
Good thing you have a whole